Okay, we continue from last lecture. We are now going to talk about power series and when do they converge or not. Look at this power series as an example. You see, it has a variable name. I mean, that's the definition of power series, right? Where the variables are increasing to the power. So, for some axes, the series may converge and for some it may not. So, you can think of this as a function. This is your f of x. Okay? And the question is, what is the domain of this function? Right? Where is this power? So the domain will be automatically this axis for which the series will converge. Right? I mean, this is no different from saying if you had a function g of x equals 1 over x minus 3. Right? This function is not defined at 3, but it is defined at 6. Right? So what about this guy? Well, I picked this example as an easy example. You can see this is a geometric series, right? Let me rewrite it slightly differently so you understand what I'm saying. Let's put that n out here, right? So this is a geometric series where each term is x minus 1 over 3 to the power n, and n starts from 0 to infinity. Well, we know geometric series very well. Yes, we know they converge if that common ratio absolute value is strictly less than 1. Right? So, what happens here? If I plug in 4, what happens? 4 minus 1 is 3, 3 at the top, 3 over 3 is 1. And then, so, f of 4 becomes the series 1 plus 1 plus 1 plus 1. Right? So, 4 is not in the domain of this function. On the other hand, if I plug in 2, 2 minus 1 is 1, I get the summation of 1 third to the power n, which converges, right? It has a finite value. So this shows you that, okay, 2 is in the domain of this function, 4 is not, right? So in general, what happens with power series? Sometimes some points in the domain, some are not. And how could the different domains of different power series look like? So there's a theorem that talks about that. Now, one thing, let's notice one thing. If it's, you know, x minus c, right? If you plug in c itself, it's always going to converge, right? If I plug in 1 itself, what am I going to get? I'm going to get zeros everywhere, except the first term, which is the constant term. So every power series automatically converges for c itself, where you have centered it. But beyond that c, it may or may not, okay? Let's write down that theorem. So we just said that C itself, if I plug in C here, I get 0, 0, 0, except A0 would be, you know, times 0 to the power 0, so that so you will have the constant term for when you plug in x equals C. So one possibility is that it converges only for x equals C. Second possibility, it converges for all x where x minus c absolute is less than r and r is a number bigger than 0. Okay? And third possibility, it converges for all x, okay? Meaning the whole number line. So it converges for all x where possibilities, single point, a finite interval around the, right? What's the picture here? Let's draw the pictures next to it. So you may have something like either it converges only at c or you may have a distance of, what does this mean? The distance of x to c is less than r. So you might have something like this, right? So this distance is r, and this distance is r, and it converges for all x's in this interval, okay? Or it converges for the whole number line, right? The whole number line is in there, okay? Let's define a couple of terminologies with respect to what this theorem says. We're not going to go over the proof of this theorem, it's beyond the scope of this course for now, but we say this R is called the radius of convergence. Okay? And so the three possibilities of R are, R could be just zero, just C converges and nobody outside it. R could be a finite number, right? Or R could be infinity. Because think of it like the radius, you're starting at C, and you can go infinite this way, all x's, if you plug in them, converge. And finally, one last definition is the interval of convergence is the set of all values of x for which the power series converges. Okay? Now, what do the intervals of convergence look like? Again, either the single point C, a finite interval. Notice we have not said anything about when x minus c exactly equals r. We're going to come to these possibilities in a few minutes. So the interval could be closed or half closed, half open or completely open. Or the interval of convergence could be the whole number line. So in the next lecture, we will do a few examples to calculate intervals of convergence.